Natalie was diagnosed with a brain tumor on the top of her brain stem. So she's had three very difficult brain surgeries. So she's had a very challenging young life. It also left her left side compromised, mostly with the facial paralysis on her left side.
This surgery that we're having at this time is much, much better than brain surgery.
For her, this is a huge undertaking because she always says, I want people to know how I feel on the outside because I'm happy on the inside.
I think that with this smile surgery, it will just make me more confident in school and in different public places. And just when people will see me, I can smile the biggest smile that I can, and I can be more friendly, and they'll see the spirit and the smile that I have on the outside.
So our favorite thing is the fact that this is a happy surgery, if there is such a thing.
Bigger than any Christmas list for her is just to be able to have a smile. So we're very grateful for the opportunity to be here and have that possibility.
Smile reanimation surgery as a whole is a very unique thing across the country. Facial paralysis in general is a at best undertreated problem for patients. There's just not a lot of people out there that do much of anything for patients with facial paralysis. So at best, it's undertreated. At worst, people will go untreated completely. This center here at the University of Iowa, which I began when I got here almost 2 years ago, is one of only a few comprehensive facial nerve centers in the country that specialize, that focus in and devote a significant amount of our resources, my time and my practice to the treatment of patients with facial paralysis. So it's very unique to Iowa, absolutely. It's very unique to the Midwest and really the West in general. The way that Natalie is undergoing this surgery is a two-stage procedure. So a year ago, we harvested or brought up from her right leg the sural nerve, which is a sensory nerve, and we used that nerve graft to sew to a branch of her working facial nerve that gives some smile on her right side. And we sewed into that branch, and then we tunneled underneath her lip and buried the tip of that nerve graft under the left side of her lip over here. And then it's been a matter of waiting for that nerve to regenerate and be ready to accept another nerve graft, which is going to be the second stage of the surgery. So in that surgery, we take a part of her gracilis muscle, which is from her inner thigh, and we put it up into the face. We hook it up around the muscles of her lip, and we sew the artery and vein in so that it can get blood flow in and blood flow out to keep the muscle alive. And we suture that nerve that goes to the muscle to the nerve graft that we put in last year. That gives this muscle, once it gets regenerated and the nerve starts working, an opportunity for this muscle to be powered by this native facial nerve. It gives her the opportunity to have an involuntary, natural, what we call mimetic smile, which is an automatic one that she doesn't have to think about. And so it'll take around 6 months for Natalie to start to see movement in that muscle. That's a function of the nerve regeneration from the end of the nerve graft that we sewed to all the way into the muscle. It just takes time for those nerves to regenerate. So about 6 months for her to probably start beginning to see the motion. And then over the course of the next 6 to 12 months after that, we may continue to see improved movement and more movement.
Wow, seeing Natalie the first time coming out of surgery was just unbelievable. It was just so much fun you could noticeably see that there was a difference, obviously, in her smile.
She was definitely thrilled, beyond her wildest dreams, I think, even.
Natalie's surgery yesterday went really well. I was very pleased with every aspect of it. We were able to do exactly as we had planned to do, using her gracilis muscle, transferring that up to the paralyzed side of her face. We easily found the tip of the nerve graft that we had put in there before. We were able to put her smallish size vessels together, and the blood flow in and out of the muscle was very, very nice. And then we were able to sew the nerves together, and everything really from start to finish went really nicely.
Dr. Henstrom is awesome. He's so nice, and I said that he's more of an artist and not a doctor because he wants to, you know, make me the best that I can be, and I really like that about him. I think that with the smile, I'll be able to show my happiness that's inside.